Let's talk about tissue plasminogen activators, or TPAs. Let's look at the names of TPAs. We are saved by the suffix because most of these medications end in ACE. The common ones are Adiplace brand name Activase, Retiplace brand name Retivase, Streptokinase, and Tenecteplase brand name TNKase. TPA is a thrombolytic drug. Thrombo is referring to a blood clot, and lytic is having to do with lysis or destruction. You may hear TPAs also referred to as fibrinolytics. Fibrino is referring to fibrin. This is because TPA binds to fibrin in the clot. And again, we have lytic, which is having to do with lysis or destruction. So this medication breaks up blood clots that are occluding vessels, but how do they do this? TPA binds to the fibrin of an existing clot. Fibrin is a protein that helps form blood clots. Then it converts plasminogen to plasmin. Plasmin is what helps break down fibrin. This causes the clot to bust apart or dissolve. This is why you will very commonly hear these medications called clot busters. Since the clot is no longer obstructing blood flow, the blood vessels will reopen, causing blood flow to improve. Okay, let's look at some therapeutic uses. TPAs are used for acute myocardial infarctions, which is obstruction of blood flow to the heart caused by a clot. An ischemic stroke is an obstruction of blood flow to the brain caused by a clot. And pulmonary emboli, or PE, which is an obstruction of blood flow to the lungs caused by a clot. Now, what do all of these have in common? They all have clots that are blocking blood flow. Again, this medication is a clot buster, breaking apart the clots in these conditions, improving blood flow to the heart, brain, and lungs. Let's talk about the must-know side effects of TPAs. Since TPA is breaking down fibrin and fibrin helps form clots, these patients will be at a high risk for internal bleeding. Symptoms of internal bleeding are abdominal pain, coffee ground emesis, or vomit that looks like coffee grounds. This indicates there was bleeding at some point. Now, dark color is old blood in the intestinal tract, but bright red blood would indicate that there's an active bleed. Other symptoms are hematuria, or blood in the urine, hemoptysis, or coughing up blood, and black tarry stool. This means there is or has been bleeding somewhere along the GI tract. Since this is a high-risk medication, there are some special considerations regarding this administration. We need to avoid new injection punctures. We want to avoid IM injections, starting new IVs, and sub-Q injections should all be avoided due to the risk for bleeding. You should also administer this medication 3 to 4 hours after the onset of symptoms to allow the medication to break apart the clot quickly. Okay, let's look at some contraindications. TPAs are contraindicated in anyone who is at high risk for bleeding. So do not give this medication to those who have an active bleed, who had a recent head trauma, a history of a hemorrhagic stroke, or uncontrolled hypertension, which is anything equal to or over 180 over 110. Okay, let's review some of the most commonly tested on information for TPAs. TPAs are used to dissolve clots to prevent blockage of vessels. TPAs work quickly to dissolve the clots. TPAs cause a high risk for bleeding, and they should be administered 3 to 4.5 hours after the onset of symptoms. If you want more information like this, you can find it in the Complete Pharmacology Flashcards. It covers everything you need to know in your pharmacology class, but it's presented in a fun and condensed way, no more textbook fluff. That's all for tissue plasminogen activators. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Happy studying, future nurses.